The bag was coarse, heavy canvas material, weighed down by ammunition. Carrie counted 3 long magazines, a shorter one, and a pistol. The metal was ice cold, sticky on the skin. Hector Tolstoy unclipped the spent magazine with his thumb. It clattered to the floor. He held the weapon steady while Carrie clipped in the fresh one.
"Check for wounded," he said.
Carrie obeyed, as if they were working together in the field. She began asking herself where Hector Tolstoy got his weapons, which would be a big risk to have on a train. But this was Russia, a violent place. He had them. He had shot her enemy. He had his reasons for helping her. She went through the process of checking the dead, laying her fingers against the neck of each one, skin warm, cooling fast, nervous system settling, muscles twitching. First the boy, and she worked her way around. The soldier who loved horses lay curled up against the container, protecting his pregnant mare. Dead. Hector picked up the scarf and handed it to her. It was warm, weighty, full of colors. He lifted the trapdoor near the stool. Clumsily, with just his good hand, he removed metal bars on which the soldier had hidden his weapons.
"Before Oleganorsk, the train will stop on a red signal," he said. "You go down through here and come out on this side."
He pointed to the right of the rail car.
"There is a bank with bushes which will give you cover. Stay hidden until the train has gone. Go up the bank and you will come to the road. If there are people, stay hidden and wait. If it is empty, walk north 100 meters to a bigger road. Mikhail will be there in the green Skoda. Wear the red scarf so he can recognize you clearly."
Beneath her feet, through the trap door, the ground rushed by. Rail track, sleepers, caked ice.